IPPB stands for Intermittent Positive Pressure Breathing. It's a patient-triggered, pressure-cycled form of noninvasive positive pressure ventilation that can assist with lung expansion. It delivers positive pressure during inspiration and then returns to atmospheric pressure during expiration. The machine is capable of providing full ventilatory support, however, that is not its intended use. IPPB was designed to help patients take deeper breaths, stimulate a cough, and prevent or decrease atelectasis. It's effective in doing so because it improves gas exchange, increases lung compliance, and reduces work of breathing. Some other potential outcomes of IPPB therapy include improved breath sounds, increased oxygenation, improved vital capacity, improved chest x-rays, and a stronger cough. As previously mentioned, IPPB is helpful in treating and preventing atelectasis, which refers to a collapse in the alveoli of the lungs. IPPB is often recommended for post-operative patients who are unconscious or too sedated to perform incentive spirometry. The contraindications for using IPPB include the following: an untreated pneumothorax, hemoptysis, active tuberculosis, and a current pulmonary hemorrhage. Now let's talk about making adjustments to the IPPB settings. For example, if you want to give the patient a larger tidal volume, you would want to increase the pressure setting. To give a smaller tidal volume, you need to decrease the pressure setting. To give a faster breath, you must decrease the inspiratory time, and you can do that by increasing the flow. To give a slower breath is the opposite. You must increase the inspiratory time, which you can do that by decreasing the flow. A common error that occurs with an IPPB is when the machine doesn't cycle off. When this happens, it likely means that a leak is present. This means that the pressure limit will not be reached, and that is why the machine will not cycle off. To fix the leak, you must check the circuit and tighten up any loose connections. Furthermore, it's common for leaks to occur near the mouthpiece when a patient is not making a tight seal with their lips. In this case, you should recommend the use of a Bennett seal in order to correct the leak. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.